Lagos State Deputy Governor recently said that Okada-related accidents have been dropped from 28 accidents to 7 since the ban was effected. With this statement, how true is the entire picture of banning Lagos Okada riders in certain areas in Lagos State? In your view, when you heard this report, did it give you an encouragement that, okay, they've done the right thing by banning Okada? Or
you ban Okada and there are no more Okada accidents, it goes without saying. I mean, it's obvious, stating the obvious, of course. But I read the article and he talks about that the reason why this ban was made was for safety reasons and for security reasons. So there's also a part where they feel that these people have been used as mules or for, you know, using their Okadas to transport arms and ammunition. So I would have loved actually to hear what the data on that says. Mm-hmm. Have they been able to catch more people who are doing that, or have they been able to stop the movement of these arms? And have they been able to follow a trail to find out where these people are getting the arms?
He's saying that nobody has a child, raises up his child to become an Okada rider. It's not a career, it's not a job anybody should aspire to. So circumstances have brought people who should be doing other more productive community developing kind of jobs into riding bikes. Yes, it's meeting a need, but it's not a safe job. And 21 lives, big deal. This is 21 from 27 hospitals that usually have 28 people dead. Having 7 is a big deal, and we must applaud that. It's a good deal, it's a good thing. So what I wanted to say was, when he was given the option of why you shouldn't do this as a job, he said people should consider other kind of jobs like welding, vocational trades. And my thought was, so what was the plan to take these people from Okada into other vocations? As in, I want an holistic government. I want a government that has thought through the entire plan and said that as we ban the Okada, when we seize your bike, we register every one of you. We put you in a training center. We train you with a skill. We help you find a job. Yeah. That is what I want to hear.
Yeah, but a government wouldn't want to train non-Nigerians. They are claiming that many of these bike riders are not not just if they are Nigerians, fine. But according to the money, they're from Niger, they're from Chad. These are people that are not Nigerians. So why would I want to train
Nigerians? They
you can't
are
go
Nigerians.
By the ones that you write.
Yeah, but
I'm talking about
a
government that has a holistic view on who and who are in their within their own jurisdiction.
Thank you, Mr. Governor and Mr. Deputy Governor, for the ban. Because the reality where me I live is that we've had relief. I went to Lasso on Thursday. I went to Lasso on Friday. Usually when you leave Lasso, if you leave Lasso at 4:30, between 4:30 to 7, there's no way you'll get across Iyanoba. This is a 10... Okpoju, that there's traffic, 10 minutes drive to Volks, that you will leave that place in 2 hours. And the cause of traffic is nothing but one-way drivers and Okada riders. When you are driving, they will be hitting on your car with all sorts of things. You have to wait for them to go and wait for them to be a bit sane. The only saving grace usually is a naval officer trying to get to Navy barracks or job barracks. That's the only way you can go through Lasso to my end of town. And I went to Lasso on Thursday at 5 to 6. I was still in Lasso. I had not finished my business because a friend of mine needs a referral for her master's, and I've been going to Lasso for that. And I was worried that how will I get home? How will I get through that area? And I drove through town. I went like again that. On Friday, so, just like that.
Just like that.
So even if there are bike riders still disobeying the law on Badagry Expressway, which should be, and I didn't see enforcement, they largely reduced that menace that we had.
Okay, so according to also, in addition to what he said, the police reports suggest that many of these these bike riders actually have weapons in their bikes.
Yes.
Many have knives.
I was going, you did not let me finish.
Yes.